What's up, you guys, and thank you for joining From Tired to Trained, where we get our tired bodies fit and our tired brains
functional.
So you want to make some eye-catching thumbnails, and you want to make sure it stands out and gets the views that you deserve. That's why today we're checking out Canva, where you can make your thumbnails free of charge and you don't need any software or you don't need to be a graphic designer. I'm also going to share with you 5 essential steps that you need to take using Canva in order to make some banging thumbnails. So stay tuned, let's check this out. Welcome back, everyone. So making the right thumbnail can be fun, but it can also be a pain if you don't have the right tools or you're not sure what you're doing. But not to worry, you see, today I'll show you how to make a banging thumbnail. Don't forget, if you want to learn more along the way about improving your content, do smash that subscribe button and do smash the hell out of that bell for updates. So let's get this started. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and open up an internet browser and type in canva.com. Now, just like many sites, you are going to have to go ahead and do a quick sign up in order to start using their service. Don't worry, it's quick and easy, hassle free. Now, just to give you guys a quick heads up, I do currently use the free version, so that works fine, but you know, the paid version does give you a little bit more perks. But before I continue, this is not supposed to be a sponsored video. I do use Canva for most of my thumbnails, and I had a ton of requests to do this tutorial, so hey, this is why I'm here hooking it up. The first thing I wanted to show you guys is how to start your project. Simply select the YouTube channel art, or you can choose the dimension yourself on the top right hand corner. Now you may ask, why would I change the dimension? Google recommends we use 1280 by 720. However, many recommended if you want to have that high definition look, you should use 1920 by 1080. So for the simple fact of conforming, let's go ahead and use the YouTube thumbnail option, which is a 1280 by 720. All right, so once it opens up at the very top left, you're gonna see a toolbar full of options. It's gonna show you file, resize, undo, redo, help. And to the right, you're going to see the share option and make public option, as well as the download option. Now, if we go back over to the left, you're going to see some other options such as search, layout, elements, text, background, and uploads. You can probably start to see how easy this looks. Trust me, it's easy to use. All right, so now that we got that out of the way, let's review the 5 most useful options. And trust me, with these 5 options, you're definitely going to up your thumbnail game. So the first option is the layout. Now you can choose from some helpful options they have, or you can create your own. So for this example, let's go ahead and create our own. The first thing I do is upload the pictures I wish to use. So click upload on the left, and then you can go ahead and click upload your own image, which is the green button. Or if you want, you can go ahead and drag and drop, basically from a folder where the image is. While it's downloading, it will show you a green bar. Once that's done, just go ahead and click on the image, and right away it's going to pop up in the workspace. Now you got to size this for your thumbnail. It's important you're not taking a really small picture and stretching it out completely. Use a larger size picture if you can. So you'll notice the filter option to the top left hand of the screen. You can use that to edit your pictures if you wish. Now if you don't want to use a background picture, you can use the colors or the templates. On the left hand side, click background and you'll see those options. Now the second option I wanted to highlight is the text. This is easy. Click on the text option on the left and bam, there you have it. A bunch of text options. I normally stick to the add header and I go from there. So let's go ahead and click that. You will see a text image pop up in the workspace. Double click to change the actual text. And the top left hand corner again, you'll see some formatting options for the text such as font, color, bolding. Now this is important. Character space between the letter and lines. Definitely make sure you're using that because this will help you to get more on your thumbnail and avoid really spaced out words. Now don't forget, if you like this video, do smash the thumbs up. Now the third option that I wanted to get into is the elements. I use this to help the text stand out a lot more. Click on the elements on the left. My go-to shape is normally the square with the round edges. To me, it gives a thumbnail a smoother look. Now while we're looking there, you can also see another transparent kind of looking icon. If you go ahead and click that, you'll notice that it gives you the option to change how transparent the element looks. Now I always use this as I think it gives the thumbnail a way better look. Now the fourth option that I wanted to get into to really show you guys to utilize is the free photo section. Definitely check it out. Sometimes they have some really good photos that you can use for your thumbnail. Now the last, which is the fifth option that will get your thumbnail completely done and is easy to use and I think underrated, is the search bar. Anytime you're looking for an image, an icon, anything like that, definitely use the search bar first. It could help you get there faster. Now, for this example, go ahead and type in Instagram logo, and you can see automatically brings up some logos there. And then as well, you can go in and type in the YouTube logo, whatever logo you wish to use. There's a bunch of logos at your disposal.
So there you guys have the tutorial on how to use Canva. If you use Canva or if you've tried it before, definitely do comment below and let me know what you think. If this video helped you all, don't forget to thumbs it up. Also, do smash that subscribe button and do smash the hell out of that bell for more updates. Until next time, peace out.